At one point, it was Rosenblatt Stadium. Then it was here, TD Ameritrade Park. Now at the Charles Schwab Field. A lot of people call it the Chuck. I call it the Schwab, but we're all here. And that's the wonderful beauty of the magic and mystery of baseball. So I think we're going to start a little early. We're going to start our fun show early. We want to welcome all of you to our 2023 National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association Presentation Awards. I'm Howard Borden, your Master of Ceremonies. Thrilled to be with all of you on this celebratory Friday morning. So we have a lot of people here that we are going to recognize. And again, we are grateful that you are here. But before we start, we always have the tradition. We filled up the lineup card, and then I had to change it. So here we go with our batting order. Batting first over to my left is Bo Carter. Bo is the executive director of the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association. In the two-hole, we welcome back Tommy Allison, vice president of the Game Headwear and our presenting sponsor. Now, 32 years in the bigs, he is David Feaster, the executive director of the Dick Howser Trophy. And then in the cleanup hitter's role, Jana Howser, the Dick Howser Trophy Committee. She is the daughter, of course, of the iconic Dick Howser. We also want to recognize in the dugout our skipper, Mike Montoyer, executive associate director of the NCBWA. We are thrilled that you are here. So let's get underway as we're stepping into the batter's box for our first award. It's the Russell D. Anderson Wilbur Snipp Award. It's going to be presented by our executive director of the NCBWA, Bo Carter. Bo, welcome back to Omaha.
Thank you, Howard. I want to thank everyone for coming today. We really appreciate the, especially the Oral Roberts team. They're going to go out and take batting practice in the hall here in a minute. But glad to have you all. Good luck in the series, guys. Just very briefly, John Cox was our 2022-23 winner of the Russ Anderson Wilbur Snipp Award. That's for contribution to college baseball. 44 years as the play-by-play man for Southern Miss Baseball. Many of you are familiar with John, and he could not be here. Unfortunately, they got eliminated by one of our favorite teams there in the Super Regional. But we are appreciative of John and the great job he did. 44 years with Southern Miss. Congratulations to John Cox in absentia, the Wilbur Snipp Russell Anderson Award winner.
And we congratulate John Cox from the Golden Eagles. Now, we have a special award that we always do. It's the Stopper of the Year Award. Presenting it will be Russell Luna. He is an executive assistant director with the NCBWA. Russell, welcome back to Omaha and the big show.
Thank you, Howard.
The NCBWA's Stopper of the Year honors the nation's best relief pitcher in college baseball. This award has been presented since 2005. Previous recipients that have reached the big leagues include San Diego State's Addison Reed, Texas' Corey Knebel, and Miami's Brian Garcia. Last year's standout winner was Texas State's Tristan Stivers. This year's recipient for the Stopper of the Year Award produced some impressive numbers. He holds a 2-1 record, a 1.85 earned run average, and is tied with a nation-best 15 saves. The junior right-hander gave up 12 earned runs and 44 hits and 58.1 innings pitched. He fanned 78 batters and walked just 11, limiting opponents to a .210 batting average. He picked up his second win of the season against Oregon in Game 2 of the Super Regionals, allowing 2 runs and 4 hits and 3.1 innings pitched. This individual was voted First Team All-League and the Summit League Pitcher of the Year. He is a 2-time NCBWA All-American, a native of Rowlett, Texas. He's the third consecutive player from the Lone Star State to win this award. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2023 NCBWA Stopper of the Year from Oral Roberts University, Kay Denton.
Thank you.
There you go. Very nice.
All right, Kate, so you'll say
a few words. Yeah, let's move this back
over. Yeah. And first of all, I'd just like to say thank you for the coaching staff here at Oral Roberts University for providing me the opportunity to go out and play this game every single day. Second off, I'd like to thank our offense for giving me the opportunity to get 15 saves this year. I wouldn't be able to do it without them. And I'd just like to thank all the other guys on the team for supporting me this entire year. And I'm just so proud to be a part of this group. Let's go win it all.
Amen. Congratulations. We congratulate Cade Dent with Oral Roberts. Now we'd like to introduce Ryan Powell. Ryan is the assistant commissioner of the Summit League and a member of the NCBWA Board of Directors. Ryan, welcome back to Omaha.
Thanks, Howard. Happy to be here. Excited to be here. Obviously, this is great for the Summit League, great for Oral Roberts, and I know you guys got a game to get ready for, but you might want to stick around for this next award, too. The Mike Martin NCBWA National Coach of the Year Award is presented to the nation's most outstanding college baseball coach. The NCBWA has presented this award since 2008. Some of our previous winners include former Oregon State coach Pat Casey, Virginia's Brian O'Connor, and Tennessee's Tony Vitello in 2021. This year's Mike Martin National Coach of the Year honoree had a remarkable season. I had a front row seat to it. It was fantastic. This individual led his team to its first College World Series appearance since 1978. His team tied the program record and broke the Summit League record with 51 wins, including a nation-best 21-game winning streak. His team captured the Summit League regular season, postseason titles en route to winning the Stillwater Regional. This team has done that 20 times since 1999, won the Summit League regular season tournament titles. From there, his squad took 2 of 3 from Oregon. They won the Stillwater Regional. It's just been an incredible year, third number 4 seed to get to Omaha. Ladies and gentlemen, our 2023 NCBWA Mike Martin National Coach of the Year from Oral Roberts is Ryan Fulmer.
Talk now after that? Good Lord. Well, it's a shared award, obviously. This reward belongs to these guys in this room. It's not me. Our assistant coaches who really make this possible. This is what it's about. So it's about these guys. Cade, I'm happy for you, man. It's a great job, right? That's a big part of yours, too, just like everybody else in here. Thanks, Tim Johnson, and the support of our athletic department and university. And I'm going to get everybody back for setting me up like that, too, by the way. But thank you very much. I appreciate everybody in here, and this is theirs. This is not mine. Thank you.
Congratulations.
We congratulate, of course, head coach Ryan Fulmer with Oral Roberts and the Golden Eagles. Best of luck to all the teams, and best of luck to Oral Roberts, and thank you for supporting your coach and Cade Dent, one of your teammates. And have a great time here at the Schwab. Okay. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I have the pleasure to introduce David Feaster, the executive director of the Dick Howser Trophy Committee, 32nd year as the chairman and executive director of this prestigious trophy, and the committee does a great job putting us together and what we have to do. Welcome back to Omaha, David, again, honoring this great, prestigious award.
We We established this award primarily to promote college baseball, to promote the student athlete. And this year we have the opportunity to have someone win it from Baton Rouge. And I've been doing this for 32 years, and 25 years ago, we had the opportunity to give this award to somebody who played in Baton Rouge. But one of the key elements, besides being an outstanding human being, he epitomized what a student athlete was. Eddie Furness won the Dick Howser Trophy as the outstanding collegiate baseball player. He also epitomized the student athlete. He's now Dr. Eddie Furness, or is it Ed, or I don't know how you go. But that's what we're trying to do. That's what the coaches are trying to do, the colleges are trying to do. Gene, a legend back there, grow these people. So we had Eddie in town, so we wanted the opportunity to let him come up and just say a few words, if you would.
I was a lot skinnier then.
Well, oh gosh, you know, 25 years, a lot has changed and a lot hasn't changed. I find it interesting, it's the 25th year, but it was also, Kay Denton was number 36. I was number 36. Mm-hmm. This is the 36th trophy. So anybody else with a 36? Okay. But I tell you, it's just a huge honor to be here. And what I was thinking about on the way here was, in 98, Coach Burtman pulled me aside and he said, "Hey, Big Ed, you're going to get the Dick Howser Trophy. You've won the Dick Howser Trophy this year." And I was like, oh gosh, I must have just been slack-jawed, because there's just that was such a big deal to me. And it was so important for LSU. What I didn't realize is, you know, we'd had players like Big McDonald and Todd Walker and all these big names who played in the big leagues before I was even there. And I was the first to win it out of all those. And then it's been 25 years. We've had more good players and big leaguers come through LSU. And now it's the first time in 25 years we've had another LSU guy get the reward. So it's a testament to, you know, the excellence that you know, Paul Maneri, Coach Burtman had, and Paul Maneri continued, and Coach Johnson's bringing back, and really that air of importance of, you know, the individual players and doing the right things and being good people and having character. Because in the end, baseball goes away. You know, there's performance, courage, character on that trophy. And you know, performance is the one that goes away. It goes away for all of us, but the rest of them don't. And I think that makes this trophy special in a different way. And I appreciate the committee members. And Jana, thank you so much for having me. Thank you to the LSU family, LSU fans, for making this possible. You know, because they bring the players and they support the players, and they bring the coaches and they support the coaches. And, you know, my really heartfelt congratulations to Paul. I'm just so proud of you. It's a great honor, and I'm glad it's you, my friend. Thank you.
Now, David, we'll explain again the process here just a little bit, as Bo will too. But David, I know that this is a really tremendous that you brought somebody back. So kudos to you for doing that.
I don't play the lottery, but I would have a 36 in it today if I did. Okay.
Well, now. Again, Eddie, it's great to see you back here in Omaha. We want to reintroduce Bo Carter. He's going to explain this process that the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association puts together for the Dick Howser Trophy. Take it away, Bo.
Thank you, Howard. It's a three-step process, more or less. We start with the preseason NCBWA All-America team, which has been picked for 23 years now. The NCBWA also does Division I, Division II, Division III polls on a weekly basis. Very honored to have our PR people working with that. And I also want to give special kudos. We talked about the Russ Anderson Wilbur Snipp Award. Russ Anderson was our assistant executive director and our treasurer for over 25 years. He just passed away a couple of years ago. Wonderful human being. He kept the trophy going. So glad to have the Wilbur Snipp Award noted with that. But again, mid-season, we send out two ballots, one about two-thirds of the way, and then one final ballot during the Super Regionals. And this year, our five finalists were Jack Caglione of Florida, Dylan Cruz, teammate of Paul from LSU, Rhett Lauder of Wake Forest, winning his pitcher in the country at 15-0. Of course, Paul, and then J.J. Weatherholt, who led the nation in hitting with a .449 average. So it's a great deal. It's voted on, as David will tell you, by over 300 members of the Baseball Writers Association. It's just a wonderful privilege to be able to work with the Howser Trophy Committee. So very thank you to David, Jana, Tommy, and Howard for all the help, and our assistant executive directors.
Thank you, Bo. At this time, I'd like to introduce Tommy Allison. He's the vice president of the Game We're Head Aware, sponsor of the Dick Howser Trophy, for always a few kind words. And, Tommy, welcome to you and your family back to Omaha.
Thank you, Howard. First of all, it's an honor to be part of this award, not just professionally, but personally. Been involved with Gene for over 20 years with our company, but it's become more of a friendship. And obviously what's developed with Jan over the last several years. I couldn't be more honored to sit here today and to be a part of presenting, Paul, you this trophy. So on behalf of all of our team members at the game, I'd like to congratulate you on an outstanding season. You represent everything that this trophy and our company stand for. So your work ethic, obviously, has molded the person, most importantly, and then the player that you become. Getting to know your parents last night, know how proud they are of you and what you've done on and off the field, which is, as Eddie mentioned, you know, some of those qualities go away sooner than others, but the character, the leadership, those qualities last forever. And I have no doubt you'll carry those into your career, whatever it may be. So I want to wish you well in all your future endeavors and a bright career. And most importantly right now, I want to wish you luck here in Omaha. Again, congratulations from all of us at the game.
Thank you very much, Tommy Allison. Now we're going to get back to David Feaster is going to talk a little bit about the history of this prestigious award. Take it away again, David.
Well, thank you, Howard. Just going to go off script again, which Howard hates. Would you introduce who you mentioned and talk about him a second?
Yeah, we got involved in college baseball.
Yeah, we have a living legend in the room, so today's the recognized legend, so I wanted to touch on it.
Well, we got involved in college baseball over 20 years ago, and one of the guys that really helped get us started and get our company started in the game of college baseball, Coach Gene Stevenson. He's here with us today. He's a big part of this award, too, as he's attached to Jana. And now, he'll tell you he just does what she says, and he pretty well does. But, no, Coach has been an absolute legend in the sport, and he's meant a lot to me. He's meant a lot to our company. So, Coach, thanks for being here.
Let me tell you a little bit about the Dick Howser Trophy. Dick Howser was a two-time All-American shortstop at FSU. After his major league playing career, he went back to FSU to coach it in 1979. He returned to the majors to coach the Yankees and the Royals. And as I guess folks from Omaha would know, that Kansas City team won the World Series in 1985. After his death, friends of his in the St. Petersburg area and an FSU wanted to establish an award in his name. So initially we presented this 36 years ago at the Governor's Baseball Dinner down in St. Petersburg, Florida. In the old days, all the teams spring trained in Florida. So we'd have the Commissioner of Baseball, both league presidents. It was quite an event. And this was added to that. And so later on, we moved to Omaha, and became, obviously, this is the mecca of college baseball. So this is where we thought the award should be presented. 25 years ago, a lot of numbers coincide. Eddie Furness won. We became associated with the college baseball writers who do our selection. And as Eddie so aptly said, character integrity, our award, everybody, if you've ever tried to give out an award, objectivity is hard. And we have, I'm going to correct you, Bo, Mike says 600 people around the country selecting this winner. It's not one person in a cubicle looking at stats. We got 600 people watching the games, oftentimes keeping score at the games, working at the games. So they're there. And so that, to me, gives the character and integrity and hundreds voting on this. And it's all compiled by Mike Montoro, who puts all these All-American teams and the Dick Howser Trophy team together. And now with having some history, current winners, and with that selection process, they get it right. We are not necessarily the best pro prospect. We're supporting college baseball. What college baseball player had the best year? That's what we want, okay? And so these guys do know how to pick them. Currently, Brady Springer, Florida, in Kansas City now. Andrew Benintendi, Arkansas with the White Sox. Adley Rutschman, Oregon State Orioles. Chris Bryant, San Diego, Rockies, formerly a Cub. Anthony Rendon, Rice with the Angels. Former players, Buster Posey, FSU. David Price, Vanderbilt, Rays, and Boston, and Dodgers. Mark Teixeira, Georgia Tech, Yankees. Steven Strasburg, San Diego State, Washington. Robin Ventura, long time ago, Oklahoma State. Jason Veritek, switch-hitting catcher, Georgia Tech, Boston Red Sox. Todd Helton, Tennessee, Rockies, and Alex Gordon, Nebraska. And Bo and I were thinking the other day that largest crowd I think I ever saw was when Alex Gordon was playing, and the crowds here when Nebraska was in the tournament were quite impressive. So that's our award. We're really trying to promote college baseball, and as Eddie Furness displays, the student athlete and the best college player that year. Thank you, Howard.
Thank you very much. Now it gives me great pleasure to introduce Jana Howser Stevenson, Dick Howser's daughter, for the presentation on behalf of her, her sister Jill, and her father Dick Howser for the 36th Annual Dick Howser Trophy Award. Jana, welcome back to Omaha.
Well, thank you, Howard, and thank you, everyone, for your eloquent words, Eddie, and family, and Crystal. I can't thank you all enough for being here. You know, when we learn privately who, upon all of this voting that was forementioned, how it all fits together and comes together. And then lo and behold, we find out, and I think, wow, that was Eddie's year, his 25th, his silver anniversary of his winning it. And I, too, could not agree more that the features, the cornerstones of the award, courage, character, leadership, and performance, to see that personified now, 25 years later, Eddie, you just wear it very well. So thank you for being here. I'd like to briefly thank David Feaster with the committee and his leadership with the award. I don't know, Paul, if you know this, but when this began, I was just about your age, and it was on the heels of what had happened. And But the key is that it's something that was done by people and then stewarded by David and these other people over these years. Here we get to year 36, and with beginning, and when I became involved, not only was I very much welcomed, but it's a precious, precious time, and today is a magical day to wake up to. So I want you all to know that. So I'd like to thank David. I'd like to thank the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association. Again, a comprehensive look at Division I baseball as it relates to the Howser Trophy across the nation. is amazing to me. And what that renders, I believe, is that proper research is known. You know, it just is incredible to see how it comes together over the course of a season. So the NCBWA, the committee itself, as well as the organization. Okay, then I'd like to also thank Tommy Allison of the Game Headwear. We appreciate and so enjoy your involvement with this award and what you, the spirit of your company, and how what that embodies as well. And what an absolute honor to have a joy of collaborating with you on this. So thank you, and thank you to your family and Kelly, who's here too. Then I'd like to also thank Major League Baseball, the Commissioner's Office, for coverage of the Dick Howser Trophy, as well as the MLB Network for the coverage that will be available on out into time of these wonderful days. I'd also like to thank then Jeff Williams, Jen Rogers, and Anthony Holman with the NCAA, because you all are a huge part of making this time that we're here not only incredibly significant to us, but you also help to make it seamless. Always just welcoming, and we are always so excited to get you here and to most importantly, to see you all. Okay, I'm going to take a pause for just a moment here, because before I officially congratulate our 36th recipient of the Howser Trophy, we have a surprise of a video that we would like to show you all. So if you can either look on that screen, or I believe it'll play behind us here. Okay, now before we come up, I just need one or two more moments of time, because there's an important dimension to all of this that really gets into the traditions of the award as well. As evidenced in that highlight reel, you saw, obviously, I think all of us in this room are familiar with the concept of Alex Box Stadium and Skip Bertman Field. Skip, my dad would have been the same age as Skip. Both are South Floridians as natives. And Skip has not only been a mentor over my lifetime, and he was a dear friend of my dad's, and also my husband, Coach Gene Stevenson, by way of playing great baseball. They spent a lot of time together and competed against each other a lot, but are very close friends. When Skip, prior to, and I think a lot of people have probably seen the 30 for 30, the hold the rope that has been done that's brilliant. Skip was an assistant coach, as many of you may know, at Miami. He was an assistant to head coach Ron Frazier. Ron Frazier was one of my dad's teammates in college at Florida State. They were roommates. They were best friends. And so as I think back, and I just ask that you imagine that when I think about the tradition and being 25 years, and now with Eddie, who, and lo and behold, Skip is then his head coach, when he is privately notified of what we were doing last week, you know, getting ready to do this. that I think about all that dimension in what all of this is about. And I know this. Obviously, I know what the game means to my husband, Gene, who spent a lifetime in it, one of the most historic careers. Clearly, that's the case very much with Coach Burtman. And I would just like to say also that my dad felt that his entire life, his entire path was changed by the ability to go to college and play baseball. That changed everything in his life. And although he went on to pro ball, came back for a year and did coach at FSU, he stayed very, very, very connected to the game, which is one of the many, many reasons that I absolutely cherish and love what we do here, because I know what it meant to him. So the culmination of our year, recognized in the virtues, I think that my dad, he was friends with everyone, grew up not ever being able to quite understand how everywhere we went in the baseball setting, people would come up and say hi to him and hug him. And I have the best memories of that. But what I want you to know is that he worked hard too. We've talked about focus, being mindful about priorities and what's right in front of us, and developing the whole person. We're here talking about baseball, but really these are virtuous qualities of life. And so what an honor to have this named in my dad's memory. It's just something that means so much to both my sister, Jill, and I, and also my two nieces, his two grandchildren, Melody and Michelle. So with that, I would like to, and thank you for obliging that little bit of extra. I'd like to first have the pleasure to speak with Coach Jay Johnson, head coach Jay Johnson of LSU, regarding these details at times in the past. But it was a first notification as head coach. And I think that was hopefully one of the very first things I said in that conversation privately, is how excited I was to be able to privately inform him that this was going to be happening. So I'd like to first say, and we'll ask you to come up in a moment, Coach, but I'd also like to congratulate certainly you, Paula, but your parents as well, and thank you, Karen and Craig, for being here with us, celebrating this occasion with us. And last, I'd like to say officially we'd like to welcome Paul Skenes up as the 36th recipient of the Dick Howser Trophy for 2023. And might I add one other thing about numbers? You're number 20. I know that holds great significance in your life. So my dad, his number with the Kansas City Royals, first retired number with that program, with that team, is the number 10. My husband also wears that. But so when I saw, here's my impression, because I'm an identical twin, right? And I saw you wearing number 20, I thought Dad had two 10s. Now, well, you know, I'm not saying I'm a 10, but you know what I mean. But that was his number. So between my sister and I, if you say she's the daughter of a 10 and she's the daughter of a 10, that makes 20, and here you are. But the 36 is good. So I did. But you know, numbers mean a lot to us, too. Number 10 was also retired. That was my husband's number at Wichita State. So that's what I'll say about the numbers. So I'd like to congratulate you. I'd like to welcome you up. I'd like for everyone to hear a few words from Paul Skenes. Come on up, and congratulations as the recipient of the Dick Howser Trophy.
As I think back on this year, and I've had some time to reflect and look back on the last 10 or 11 months, and you know, the last couple years, you know, since I've been in college, and more so the time I've been at LSU, all I can think about is the people that I've had around me, making me better. Obviously, the support I've had from my parents and my family. Support I've had from my coaches, and just, you know, throughout my career and the time that I've been playing baseball, how lucky I've been to have the right people around me pushing me and making me better the whole way. So that's all I have to say.
All right. Thank you. That's wonderful.
Again, we congratulate our 2023 Dick Howser Award winner, Paul Skenes. Paul, Enjoyed visiting with you last night and this morning, and best of luck, of course, to all the teams here at the tournament and your future endeavors on and off the field. You're going to be a great representative of our award. Congratulations to you.
Thank you.
Coach up.
Yeah, we're going to do that right now. he's been patiently waiting, and I had a great time visiting with him last night about old school and new school college baseball. So, good friend of ours, the head coach of LSU, bringing up to the dais, Jay Johnson. Jay, welcome back to Omaha. Congratulations for getting your team here as well.
Yeah, it's awesome to be here. And this award, you know, I've always viewed as the Heisman Trophy of college baseball. And when you look at the qualities of the award, I don't think there's a person, player in the country that could represent it better than Paul Skenes. So when you start with the courage part of it and you think about his journey and where he started at the Air Force Academy, I mean, how do you have more courage than to say, hey, I'm going to start by trying to go serve my country? And that's amazing in itself. Performance, when I look at performance, this is the most dominating season I've ever seen a college pitcher have. He is absolutely worthy of the award by the performance on the field. Fred and I, as a head coach with him on the mound, is a lot better than any I've ever experienced in my entire life. Makes a lot of my decisions a lot better. So congratulations, Paul, on a terrific year. Leadership. I can't quantify the impact that he has had. He's only been in our program for 10 or 11 months, but that impact will last long after he's gone. And then the last part of it, of character, there's not a better human being on the planet. And just a small story, you know, this is probably a month and a half, 2 months ago, we're rolling along, number one in the country, and we were talking about something else. And he said to me, like, hey, coach, how can I help you keep this going once I'm gone? And he wasn't talking about the winning or any of that. It's like the dynamic that we have in our locker room and on our team that has largely been shaped by the human being that he is. So I'm incredibly proud of the strikeouts, the wins, and all of that. But the person that he is in this award is amazing. And, you know, I'll be thankful for Paul for making the decision to come to LSU for the rest of my life. And should be very proud, and I'm very proud to be his coach. So congratulations, Paul.
Again, Jay, we thank you very much for your mentoring student athletes, and welcome back to Omaha to Alex Box North. Now, before we have some photo ops for everybody, we really are very grateful to all of you for being part of our family every single year when we celebrate this wonderful game and all of our prestigious awards. So we would like to thank, of course, our Dick Howser Trophy Committee. We'd like to thank the NCAA, Anthony Holman and Jeff Williams and Jen Rogers, Adam Helgop with the Major League Baseball Network, our board of directors from the National Collegiate Baseball Writers Association, with LSU helping coordinate some things, Scott Woodard, the director of athletics, Coach Jay Johnson, baseball SID, a good friend of mine, Bill Frankees, and, of course, to Tommy Allison and the game headwear. We thank all of you for sharing your baseball weekend with us. We're honored that you're here. That concludes our 2023 awards presentation. Have a wonderful time here in Omaha. We welcome you. We see you. You're part of the family now. And have a great day. Let's play ball. Thank you.